Should the Constitution protect American Muslims? This question was posed by Lieutenant General William Boykin in an article published recently in which he attacked Islam, saying Sharia provides, quote, no individual freedoms while virtually enslaving those who live under its authority.
His assertion that Islam and Muslims and their free speech should not be protected is quite problematic and is an alarm for not only Muslims, but for all Americans.
Boykin served as Deputy Undersecretary of Defense for Intelligence under Bush II from 2003 to 2007 in the heat of the so-called war on terror.
He was a top general in the U.S. military, a top official at the Pentagon, and he was making inflammatory statements about Islam and Muslims while he was in uniform, and it was hurting our nation's image at the time when we have military forces all over the Muslim world, and that's why he basically had to step down.
A born-again evangelical Christian, the retired Army general is no stranger to controversy, having made anti-Islam statements before.
He's also repeatedly mentioned the fact that Islam is of satanic origins, and it's something that's quite problematic and troubling for us, especially when he was in uniform, that a representative of our nation's army would make statements like that.
Council on American Islamic Relations spokesman Ibrahim Hooper had this to say.
He obviously has his own personal religious views that he wants to impose on other people, and then he accuses Muslims of trying to do the same thing.
Sharia law has recently been criticized in legislators throughout the U.S. Although it's never been legalized in any part of the country, Oklahoma has already banned it, and many other states are taking its lead.
It's a growing phenomenon to target Sharia as if Muslims are trying to take over the country. It's completely bogus, a complete fantasy on the part of right-wing extremists, but it's being accepted in certain quarters and being promoted and exploited in a cheap attempt to get some political support by right-wing politicians.
Comments like Boykin's are being increasingly vocalized across the American political spectrum, leading to concerns by Muslims in the U.S. that this is yet another sign of the rising tide of Islamophobia. Marjanasi, Press TV, Washington.